Jesper?
You... I thought you were dead.
What happened here?
They tried to storm the temple. As the Grand Master said they would. We tried to stop them, but... they were just too many of them. He came back. Just when we thought it was too late.
What did he say?
But Sakarish, Yuslan, and you... He said that the High Ones got you. That he had the Luminos with him, and that he would save us all.
He lit it.
Yes. Just then, the Nile news broke through the gate. But it all happened so quickly. It was this flash, and then suddenly this rift in the sky. The light. It burns us. Can't you feel it?
I am different. It's hard to explain.
Tell me one thing about you which isn't. But I suppose it doesn't matter anymore, does it? I don't have much longer. I can feel it. Tell me, my fair lady. Why? Was the beacon a trap? From the very beginning? I thought it would save us.
It could have, but we never found the Numenos, Jesper. Sherim destroyed it. Arantheel lit the beacon without it, and this is what triggered the cleansing.
What? But... you're here. That must mean something, right? You can stop it. You have to.
I can and I will, yes.
Yes. Of course you will. That's what you do. It's strange, isn't it? The way life sometimes goes. Here I am, Jesper Delverick, the man who for once in his life wanted to be part of something good. Yeah, some great hero I am. But you know what? I don't regret it. Is that you? I did it.
This is your doing. You caused the cleansing.
What? No, you're going, darling. I saved them. Don't you see? I led them to the light.
A great philosopher once said that every change begins with a moment of lucidity. In these moments, a veil opens, one which normally shrouds all the unwelcome truths we're aware of, but which we have buried deep within ourselves where we cannot see them. And it is only these moments in which we can make a decision. The decision to either act, or to let the moment pass until the veil seals itself again and we once more are the slaves of our habits. I don't believe in revolutions. They are too simple, too fiery, and they too often end with the opposite result of what was intended. But neither am I a cynic who has lost all faith in the world. Change is possible, but it won't come as a big bang, but rather as a long path, one that will constantly confront us with obstacles. Obstacles we can either choose to overcome, or at which we choose to quietly turn around and go back to being what we were. The sacrifice of the one who will be remembered as the prophetess is proof that I am right. Yes, some might see the downfall of Enderal as the triumph of the High Ones, but it wasn't. It was neither that nor a triumph for mankind. What we were granted was a moment of lucidity, the chance to start our own walk down a long, rocky path. The High Ones exist because we believe in them. We, our egos, give them their power. And the more we listen to their words, the more we hate them, the more powerful they become. Indeed, the beacon, this ancient machine of unknown origin, can destroy us. But it can also free us from the High Ones once and for all. If we use it right. Rumors that the Aesthethians have started constructing a second beacon, and the knowledge that this time we are aware of its nature, give me hope that the woman I loved has not died in vain. And that we continue walking.